This week, Garen and Ellie head back up to work on the Earthbag cabin. We convert the back half of the truck into a water trailer, and Shae catches spring fever and starts an herb garden.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
All right, guys. Can you guess where we're headed?
Yeah, we're gonna get back up to the cabin, see what kind of shape it's in. I think it's gonna be perfect when we get up there. See if the roof leaked at all.
Just get right back up where we were, get the stucco up, the floor done, so windows in.
There's a list. Interior, finish the exterior.
We're really excited to get back up there.
It's gonna be fun to get back up there and start working on it again. It's just like spinning in the back of our minds, you know?
Gotta finish the project, you know?
And camp out with our generator and our solar panels.
Driving up. See the building over there? First glimpse of it. There it is. Nice. Everything looks to be in good shape still. Gotta pull our trailer up through there and back her in now.
Get our RV all set up, get more settled in here, and then start working away. So sometimes you're in need of some stuff, and you're like, where do I get this stuff? Well, you just take the stuff you have and cut it up, and you get your stuff.
We have this truck that we get some parts off of. It doesn't have a bed or, you know, it's like no engine, much left on it. We need a water trailer.
Our original idea is obviously to pull it from the front.
Yeah, we had an idea of just putting these right here on the top and bottom, and then just come along the front, pieces together.
We have a trailer hitch down here. What if we just pulled it from the back? So our trailer hitch is actually up here. Take a bar, put it out from the trailer hitch out this way, and then we get two supports to weld it across this way, and then that could be our trailer hitch.
We're pulling the whole thing backwards as opposed to pulling it forwards.
I love it.
I think we can do that. I think
we can too.
It's actually surprisingly light.
Way lighter than I thought.
I think that if we were kids, this would make an amazing lightsaber.
Bryce and I were looking at this thing going, hey, you know what? We could probably just cut the back end of the truck off, the frame, and create a water trailer from that. Normally, you would probably hook onto the front end of this and just kind of pull it like normal. But we got to looking at it going, you know, we'd have to take the cab off of it and use the pieces from that to build our front end for the tongue. We thought, no. Let's just cut it off and run it backwards. I mean, the differential has a reverse in it. Frontwards, backwards is all the same for it. It's transmission that makes all this frontwards, backwards stuff important.
Excellent. And then you got this cut off back here?
Yep.
Oh!
Well, it's actually not that heavy. It's pretty well...
pretty well balanced.
Pretty well balanced.
Oh, lolly.
We have a place to put our spare.
Spare tire goes up underneath there.
That's a good point. You really could put a spare there.
That's what we're going to.
Oh!
That's the whole...
taking one off of this truck.
Oh, I love it. That's so cool.
These Dodge Hubcaps have got to stay on here. On that water?
Wait, is that differential backwards?
Wait, what?
Hearing some talking over there. I think they're over there. Gary and I were in the house and we're hearing this noise over here. We're gonna go check it out.
Yeah, it kind of sounds like it's Santa's workshop over here.
What is going on? What is it?
I've got a little bit of feeling on my tongue.
Oh.
What boxes?
Planter.
Is this
all good?
For herbs?
Can we
throw it on there?
For herbs,
the plant.
Yes.
Oh, is it going to be upright, Shae?
Yeah, I'll show you it. I'll show you. It's almost done.
Shae, is this going to go inside your room or on? Okay.
Isn't that a bat or a piece of plastic?
I think it's a piece of plastic, yeah.
Okay, looks like a bat.
Yeah, it's a piece of plastic. It sounded better when you said it was a bat.
One sec.
Oh, wow. Whoa. You're daring, Bryson.
Obviously, the purpose of this thing is puppy storage. He blends in quite well with the color.
Yeah.
Want it? Lay a little mesh, like a metal mesh or something in the bottom, so the dirt doesn't just feed out. Interesting is if you watered one, probably dripping the other.
It's so cool, Shae. Did you find that online or did you design it yourself?
I found it online.
Just found a picture and kind of figured it out from there.
see what this thing is all about.
We're gonna bring it in, see how it looks in the kitchen. Try it in there for a while. If we don't like it, we'll move it to my room.
It was supposed to be in Shae's room.
More convenient, plus Mom likes plants in the kitchen. Where do you want it, Mom? Oops.
I don't know, where are you thinking?
The wall, it goes like this.
Ah, okay.
Right, and then you put the plants in here. I just put some of this, kind of this breathy, thick material in at the bottom because I had these little cracks that I don't want the dirt going through, but I still want some air to come up and maybe still keep everything airy. This thing is perfectly designed to be up against a wall, and I'll show you why. It has little cuts in it so that it lays flat, and then we have the slanted feet for the floor. No digging into the floor, no digging into the wall. It's very nice. Bryson thought of that.
Hey guys, what do you think? Okay, we're back at it.
Back at it again.
We're gonna break into it, see what it looks like inside.
We're gonna open up the building and see what the inside looks like, see if it's leaked.
Okay.
Everything's still in here.
That's nice.
It's pretty dark in here.
Yeah.
We can get some windows in.
It's looking great, exactly what we expected to see. There's a small hole here where the bear crawled in, but it's nothing we can't fix.
Not the fact there's any leaks.
And then we'll probably work on the windows because it's pretty dark inside. The window frames are all boarded up.
We are going to be putting some windows in. So we gotta get this board off and stuff out of the inside.
Frames didn't settle at all with the building, which is really nice. Sometimes they do a little bit, you know, they'll knock out a square just a little bit.
All right, looks like it's all ready for a window.
Party.
When we first went to build that building and it fell over, we had already accumulated a bunch of supplies. We went to the city and we got these windows off of Craigslist. They were really nice windows. They're like triple panes, brand new. And they've just been sitting up there gathering dust. I can't believe they're not broken or anything because they've been up there for like 5 years now.
Yeah, even the screens were good still.
Yeah, but the windows just slipped right in. It was really smooth for putting in windows. So
it did not take us long.
Alrighty, we got all the windows in. This is the master bedroom, I guess. It's the one with the bathroom in it. And then here's this guy, the living room, kitchen, and the other bedroom. Got all of them in. It's so much lighter in here. These windows are perfect for this, I think. They're nice and bright.
Yeah, it definitely brightened it up in there. With the big door frames to the bedrooms, it's cheery in there now. It's really nice.
My room a little bit, and I decided to move my hanging chair to the outdoors.
Only for the most passionate of nappers.
Let me know if it breaks.
If I fall, you'll know it's not in a good spot. I think it's pretty good.
A little teepee. What do you think, Chip? How do you like the new digs? Fine? Yeah.
To make the tongue part of it, we've used some of this channel metal. We have some 3-inch channel metal. H-J-U, I don't know what you call it. It's a long metal bar. And it works really good. It's nice, it's got a nice thickness to it. But it's gonna require a lot of cutting, a lot of grinding to get it to fit into place. So a lot of extra work cutting, a lot of extra work grinding. Some angles and pieces coming down that are at a little bit more of like a 25 degree angle down. So it's gonna have to be kind of specialized. These bolts right in here set in a perfect spot for us to kind of flange down, drill a hole in it, place it right inside, and bolt right up. Perfect. The bolt was already there. It's already part of the system, so. Let me entertain you. Push it in. Bang it in all the way. Perfect. On to the button. All right, to the 16th. can.
Maybe this corner and this corner right here.
We're going to be putting all the pieces together, and we're going to tack weld it with a line feed that we have, a line feed welder. Then we're going to pull it over to the 30 amp pole where I have a regular arc welder over there. Before we got it over there, we started kind of getting it up in the air to kind of move it. We ran into another problem.
It doesn't turn.
So now what?
Not a problem on straight roads.
We'll just drive the thing straight. Never turn it.
The rear end is a positraction rear end, and it doesn't turn very well.
I gotta take that thing apart.
Oh, behind this thing right here, there's a spider gear in there.
It's a spider running on a little hamster ball?
Yeah, yeah. Hey, can I have that toolkit?
I'm so demanding. Everyone hand me everything.
I'm just gonna pull the spider gears out. Half of the spider gears, the two here. That will allow both the wheels to be able to spin.
So we're having to take some pieces out of the differential and repackage that a little bit so that we can get that thing to turn better.
All right, so I pulled out half of the spider gear and realized that this now spins freely. So there goes our plans with the propeller on the back.
Well, I knew there was a hole, but this is not what I thought would happen. So what I'm thinking we'll do is do a little something right here to shoot the water into the next bucket, and then the last one will have plastic on the bottom to keep it from leaking. Remember these ugly plastic things? We had them around our chicken boxes for the laying. Now we are going to use them
as drip controllers.
Basil, cilantro, thyme, mint, rosemary, lavender, Greek oregano, lemon balm, and curled parsley.
Looks like it's working down there too.
We built the log structure right after buying that property. We went up there and we camped for a little bit. And that was the first thing we built. At that time, I think mom and dad were planning on building a log cabin up there. And they were just kind of experimenting building with logs. Turned out that we ended up going a different way, the bags.
So we're gonna be tearing like this and all this stuff off and building the awning that's gonna look similar to the roof. First up, we gotta tear it down.
All right. First one's coming off. Woo! Here, let me help. Woo! You okay?
It's just been sitting up there ever since we've had the property now, I guess. The log structure's been there. We built it with the idea that we were gonna tarp it and put tents underneath it, and that's what we used it for a lot of years. With just throwing a tarp on the top of it, we didn't worry about having perfectly straight rafters and all that stuff. It was just fine to lay the logs on top and put a tarp on that.
Yeah, I have a little log there.
Now that we're going to try and put a real roof on it, we want to keep the six posts when we're going to get rid of everything except the main beam going across the center. It's a really nice post up there, and I think we'll be able to just set the roof right on top of it, and it'll actually make our roof stronger.
It worked out really well when we bought the material. Well, it was kind of a mistake, but it's going to work out for the best. When we bought the material for the roof, we accidentally got way too many 2x6s.
So we ordered a little extra lumber on accident, so we thought maybe we'd use that to build the frame for the awning roof, and it was a perfect amount. We actually still have a little bit left over to do other things.
I'm not going to mention who overbought on that. It was a bang.
We wouldn't do that.
Now, all my calculations are just under, so we always have to go back to the store.
Now we can build this into a really cool little shed roof. Probably set a beam on top of this beam. We'll put a 2x6 on top, and then the whole roof will set on this main log here, basically.
We had talked about doing like an outdoor kitchen, and we thought it'd be really cool to put an awning over that so that it was sheltered over. We're gonna wait on the outdoor kitchen right now, but we thought we'd go ahead and get the porch over. That's way coming into the house, it's raining, whatever, you can get out of the rain for a minute before you get inside. It also could be used as a carport. I do think a car would fit in there.
Just gotta do things the old fashioned way, because it's always better. I'll just stand in front of my saw.
I've never built one before, but I've seen Dad build a lot, so I just kind of winged it. I called him on the phone a couple times, but you know what? I must say, I don't think he can really tell.
High's is 70s and low's is 40s, so that's comfortable.
No snow.
If
and it shouldn't
snow,
freeze.
We're turning around.
Well, I don't know if you can tell or not, but you know, we left to get out of the cold.
So now we're back here in the middle of May, and it's snowing again. Look at this. I don't know if you can see that. Like, it's not a bad snow, and it's not going to stick. But that's not the point.
It's cold.
It'll be warm, they said. It won't snow, they said. If it snows, it won't stick, they said. It's sticking.
Well, look at all that snow. Unbelievable. It's not super cold, though. It stopped, and hopefully the sun will come out, and it'll melt away.
Suzuki to good use.
Woohoo!
Ready?
Six solar panels.
Nice.
You look at them, they're beautiful. That's like almost double what we have out there.
Quite the yard sale find.
Yeah.
Never figured you'd roll up on a yard sale and see solar panels. That's unusual.
Yeah. Unused.
Unused, brand new.
It would probably just fit right on our rig.
Just perfect.
That's incredible.
All right.
For $63 a piece, pretty good.
Grow some of my own spices to spice up the food. Here's the end product. I'm really happy with it. It's a really beautiful shelf. Big thanks to Bryson and Ben for all their help.
It's gonna be a little while before we actually get to the counters. We're getting closer, and we've been really thinking a lot about how we want to do our counters. Your original idea was
concrete. It may still be that. Some of the reasons I really wanted to use concrete is that it's very sturdy product. With the overhangs that we have for the seating areas, we'll also be very sturdy with the concrete and the steel that's inside there. It's a pretty good product. But then Shelly had some other great ideas.
You know, there's a lot of epoxy ideas out there. One of the ideas we came up with is, since we have this tree in the middle of the room, the mesquite tree, we thought, well, it would be fun to have some leaves and some flowers from the mesquite tree, which are right now in season. And we thought about putting them down on the counter like this and all over the place, and then epoxying that in. I don't know what these things do once they get epoxied, if they'll lose their color. If anybody has any experience on this kind of stuff or can give us some advice as to if we should go with concrete or if we should try the epoxies,
let us know about the experience, how well it holds up, and sure love your feedback.
It's amazing. I have one sick, cool trailer.
Starting to put this thing all together, and it's coming together pretty good. And I went out and bought some parts for it to be able to put the 2-inch ball on it, some chains and some electrical stuff.
Great trailer now. Totally designed for this. As long as we don't go over corners too fast.
It does look pretty high.
Water in it, it won't be as high.
Sun's shining today, snow's gone, thank goodness. And we're gonna start putting up the sheeting.
Woo! Even the right side down?
What can I say?
It went together super easy. It was really fun to build too, because it's square, and we haven't put a square roof on in a long time. Well, I guess they just did. I and Ellie, we have not put a square roof on in a little while, so it was a lot of fun to work with.
All right, we got all the sheeting done. So now we're just gonna put our flashing on the edges, tar paper, and start the shingles.
We got the lights all set up for it now. We're about ready to plug it in. The chain's hooked up to the hitch. Wiring's all done. It's all strapped down, ready to go. Lights are on it. They're cute as all get out. And it is ready to go.
All right, well, that wraps
wraps up this week. Dad, you're going to Tennessee?
I am going to Tennessee. I'll be in T. Millington, Tennessee. They're just north of Memphis. Monday through Thursday. If you're in that area, go ahead and let us know through Twitter at MyLittleHomestead, L-I-L. If you'd like to spend some time with us and volunteer and share some of your great ideas that you have with our family, please let me know.
Yeah, I'm sure the My Little Homestead family would love to see what you got rocking.
So it has to be kind of like homesteading or earth bagging or making something weird out of pop cans. Volunteering your time to be able to come on and kind of be a part of the show.
We had a lot of requests to turn those caddy designs into t-shirt designs. So we took one of those and we did that this week. So that is the design of the week. If you'd like to get this totally awesome design, you can check out the link in the description. Yeah. All kinds of fun stuff over there.
Animal bandanas and stuff.
Oh yeah, we got animal bandanas. We got
or bananas.
Stuff over there.
Yeah, bananas.
Bananas. Along with any of our other designs, me and Dad, we woke up.
Twinkies!
Apparently we both thought, this is
the one to wear.
It's a good mama and baby goat day. Perfect. So we got all of our designs that we've done in the past over there too. So if you're interested in anything, be sure to check that out. We have free shipping going on from tomorrow through the 4th. So if you would like to get something, just hold off till tomorrow morning and get yourself some free shipping. Woo-hoo. So that's happening as well.
Save some money.
Thank you so much for being a part of our family and we'll catch you next Friday. Bye!
We did the other side because I had to figure out how to do it, and I wanted to sound smart. You ready?
So we're still. This is what happens when you have low budget lighting.
Well, I should have got that. Dang it! Oh yeah, cabin baby. Exciting.
Our family moved from the city to the country. Thanks for taking part in our adventure. We have new videos every Friday evening. If you would like to help us out, you can like this video, share it, subscribe, or support us on Patreon. See the links in the description.
Oh really?
Yes.
Isn't he right?
Oh, he's looking for a place to pee. Oh. Perfect. Exactly. Mark that territory, Chip.
Hi, Bryson.
Hi, Bryson.
How are you today?
Hi, Bryson.
Great.
Hi, guys. Yeah, you're doing a great job.
You're doing a great job.
Thanks, buddy.